from the very beginning, obviously we can and will enforce the order to the extent that we need to. But if Louisianans are going to insist that we enforce our way through this, then we're going to have a very, very hard time flattening the curve. We have 4.7 million people in Louisiana. We have tens of thousands of businesses. We have 4,500 or so churches. And so I'm counting on the goodness, the decency of the people of Louisiana to cooperate. The imperative that we've been talking about since the very first day for the people of Louisiana is to embrace these mitigation measures, the stay-at-home order, the social distancing, because if we don't greatly limit social contact, we are then not going to flatten that curve to the degree that we could, and then when we exceed the capacity of our healthcare facilities, it will be by an amount that's larger than it needed to be, and that will directly correlate to the number of people who will die. And so I'm again urging everybody in the state of Louisiana, comply. And understand this is not a problem just for New Orleans and Jefferson Parish or Shreveport or Baton Rouge. This is all throughout the state. And the guidance coming out of the White House today is in those rural areas where you don't have a large case count, don't breathe easy. The time is now to take action to make sure you don't get the cases, because you're always further behind this virus than you think you are. You are always further behind. And so if you wait until the numbers grab your attention, guess what? You just let the virus win. And we have been behind this thing in the United States and the state of Louisiana from the beginning. And so we have to do better on our compliance. And by the way, I still want to thank those people who are complying. And you have different ways to kind of measure compliance on social distancing. And I know that people's cell phones have the GPS devices, and you've got these studies that are being done. New Orleans actually has a very high level of compliance right now. So does Baton Rouge and Bossier. There are some areas that are doing extremely well. There are other areas of our state that are not doing well at all. And that's why we continue to make the point, this virus, this disease, is throughout the state of Louisiana. And everybody needs to take it seriously. And everybody is going to take it seriously at some point. It's going to be when there is a death that is close to them. Well, wouldn't it be better if we took it seriously so that that never has to happen? I think the answer speaks for itself. So I would encourage people to comply.